Oh my gosh, look at it. It's like a PE class in school. There's so many of them. Look at all the girls flocking to Connor. Like the pigeons before them. They are a flock, really. That's the only way to describe them. Hey guys, welcome back to some more Sims Spawn. This is actually an episode I've been looking forward to recording loads, because it is the first episode of a new and improved huge Suburbs household, because of course Charlie Rose and Asha brought little Noelle over here to live so that Charlie Rose can help look after her parents a bit, because her brother's Connor, and what's Connor gonna do? So I don't think he's gonna be around for too much, and if he is, he's probably not gonna be looking after his parents probably as much as they need. And also the household kind of needs a Charlie Rose in it, I'm feeling. So the Suburbs household is new and improved, bigger now. What's really cool as well is that they actually just live across the river from the Villarreals now, who've moved back in to the Villarreal family home. You guys made a good point. If he inherited his house, why did I pay 100,000 simoleons for it? I kind of feel like I should cheat and give them back 100,000 simoleons, because that makes no sense. Do you guys agree with that? Please let me know in the comments below. But today we are going to be playing with these little cutie pies. One thing I'm going to do is change Connor's outfit, because you guys don't really like it. But I'm so excited not only to go into the Suburbs house, but also our verdict on Salma I will finally give in this episode. So if you guys are excited, give it a little cheeky thumbs up, let me know in the comments below, and let's play some Sims 4 Sims 4 in the Suburbs. Also, I know you guys like to think of me as a peach juice guru, because I am. If you're a peach juice noob, I have some solid advice for you guys. Don't limit yourselves by only having one glass of peach juice. Why stop there? Two. Why stop there? I invite you to always have three glasses of peach juice on you at one time. You can do this really easily by just making one in the morning, forgetting about it, making one at lunch, forgetting about it, and then making one as an afternoon snack and forgetting about that as well. Now I have three. How magical is my life right now? And oh my gosh, what's going on? Why are there sparks coming out of here? Let's just go ahead and replace that, please. So my gosh, look at the family. We're riddled with Sims. There is absolutely loads of them. And I'm kind of thinking I'm gonna have to let this bed be reclaimed by Charlie Rose and Asha. So let's just go ahead and do a little bit of claiming of this bed, please, friendos. Because this, of course, was Charlie Rose's room when she was a teenage girl. And it kind of looks very much like a teenage girl's room. So I do think I'm gonna have to do a little bit of tweaking in here. So it's just a tiny bit more Asha friendly, because right now it ain't so Asha friendly. And also, it's 3 a.m. in the morning, you spookaroonies. Get all of the butts into bed. Noelle. You have nowhere to sleep now. Neither do you, Macy. I kind of stole their rooms. Not gonna lie to them. Okay, we're gonna have to do a little bit of tweaking to the family household. I forgot I get loads of last exceptions in this. So for the meantime, I'm just gonna have to build right now, aren't I? I'm gonna have to just go ahead and build a kid's room. I'm kind of sad because I didn't really want to give poor Noelle a sherry room option in a new house. But I can't really see a way around it, you guys. I think I'm gonna have to do it. I think these two little pookaroonies are gonna have to be doing a little bit of a share together. Plus, I guess it will actually be quite a good way for them to kind of get to know each other really well. If they're sharing a room together, you know. There's not really like much option there. You have to be good friendos, or else it's gonna be pretty awkward. So it might be a nice way to kind of integrate the two of them. I might still try though and make sure they've just got quite a lot of their own space as well at the same time. Okay, so this is super squishy. I hope it's gonna work. But I've built a little extension on the front of the house so the two girly whirlies can share a room and get to know each other a lot, because it worked for little Carrie and for Noelle. So this is their little shared room. They both have one of these like little bunk beds. Underneath there, she's got a little dresser and a little castle. They've both got little desks and a bookcase in the middle. She's got like a little, this is Noelle's side, sorry, I just was like, she. That is, I imagine, Macy's side, I imagine, because she's quite athletic. She'll just jump up there with that ladder. Because I think Noelle will want her little ladder. And then she's got like a little sofa under there and like a little toy box. Little unicorn at the side of her bed, and then they've both got like these little bedside tables. I haven't decided what I'm putting on them yet, but look, they've got like a little purple light, both of them, hanging down. You can see it from the outside, and I just thought that Like, to be fair, from the outside, it looks kinda hideous. But you know, Connor's moving out soon, so they can kind of fight for that room. I'm just putting it out there. Okay, again, family, it's kind of late. Oh, look, she's straight in there. She even knows her side, and she picked up her journal. Well done, Noelle. Can you go ahead and claim this bed and then sleep in there? They can use the dollhouse too. Great news all around. You need to claim and sleep in this one. Oh no, they can't get into bed. What is it about the bed you can't manage? Let me see if I move this. Can she get in then? No, she cannot. Maybe I've put the bed the wrong way around. What about if I twist it? Oh, guys, it was all too good to be true. Let's see if this works. Can you get in the bed now? No, she can't. How about now? No. Oh, guys. If something seems too good to be true, it usually is. What can I do? What can I do? Okay, so she can get in that bed. Okay, so I think it was a sofa underneath. Though I did go ahead and like extend the extension out a bit. So the rooms are, it's a little bit of a bigger room now. I like things being squishy because to me it's like cuter and more wholesome, but it doesn't seem like it was working too well. So I can actually give her a ladder now. I can stop that whole excuse of, oh, she's so athletic, she won't even need one. I don't want it to interfere with the dollhouse though. So I'm going to move both their ladders so they're nice and symmetrical. Hopefully they can still get to their little desks. I'm hoping they can, but these look pretty good. I'm going to use her as a little test subject for the desk. Oh, yep, can still use the desk. Okay, little one. You can go ahead and go to sleep now. Oh, she's saying she can't get to bed, but, you know, that's clearly a lie you're dreaming about there because you just got into bed. Don't be giving me that. Connor, can you get your butt home, please, and get in to sleep? And then Charlie Rose, we just need you to get to sleep now. While you're all sleeping, I'm going to go for a wee. I'm back. Yes, I wee when I'm recording with my headphones on, as you do. So I think we should probably all just take this opportunity to appreciate Usher walking down the hallway. Let's go. That's good. That is the good stuff right there. Oh, James. Oh, James, look at you. Look at, oh, you're so old. Why are you weeing in there? Oh, you're washing your hands in there. Oh, bless him. He wants to donate to charity. James, I love that. I donate to charity myself. I can understand the motivation. Why don't you get your butt in here and donate 1,000 simoleons to bunny population control? No, thank you. How about speak for the trees, love a tree? And oh, there's little Connor Rooney doing a little bit of working out while watching a TV program about Lilith. Oh wow, look at Lilith go, you guys. Beautiful, beautiful scenes of Lilith carrying a child through a burning building there. Gorgeous, well done, Lily Bear. And you guys wanted the final decision on this sad little bunny here, little Salmarini. I can't control my keyboard apparently today. On so sad little Salmarini. So I looked at both the voting that I did on Twitter. I did voting on the video itself to see what you guys would think of the whole Salma situation. And I've decided, I've taken everything into account. I'm just sending her on a cleaning frenzy while we're here. Plus, I want James to be the one that gives the final vote. Look at him. You'd never think he was old. He was old. Even in old age, he's dancing away. Look at him. He's like this dancing, like, bit of grooves. Bit of grooves, and he flicks his hands. He's like, yeah. Oh, what? And Asher's joining him. Oh, hi, Asher. Asher dancing around topless. Never gonna say no to watching that. So guys, as I said, it's gonna be James that decides what the final winners, the final verdict, and it's definitely Salma is not guilty, you guys. I think it was a glitch in the system, and I am not about to undo a lifetime of happiness with the best couple in the whole world. Have you got some high shoes on? Yeah, you do. The best couple in the whole world, Jama, strong, amazing relationship goals. They are not about to have all that of that and done because of a glitch in the system. Nah, nada. These guys will be the most beautiful couple until the end of time. I think it was just a little bit of a strange issue that we had, you guys. Oh, she wants to do a sauna. He wants to do a sauna woo-woo. I can make that happen. I am the woman you need to be asking. Woohoo in the sauna. Go enjoy yourself, kids. while you still can. Yeah. And this is great because these little guys are just chit-chatting on their own. Yay! Guys, please, 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 can you have a beautiful relationship? That would make me so happy. They're still just getting to know each other. But I think it's nice. I think it's nice. I also like that she's going to hopefully get a bit of a relationship with Uncle Connor. Uncle Connor, my gosh. Whose outfit I am going to go ahead and change for you guys because you weren't fans. You were not fans. Drink one of Beth. Three pitch dresses. Okay, so it was this outfit you guys didn't like. You're fine with that one, but you didn't think you would have such an extreme change from being like, you know, pretty streetwear-y, sort of layered to like posh little top. So I am gonna go ahead and give him a bit more of a streetwear-y first outfit as well. Just wanted him to look a little bit more grown up, guys. But if he's not there yet, he's not there yet. What can we do? There we go, guys. The classic Connor you know and love has returned. Oh, what's that? Some beautiful sauna woo-woos. Oh, catching last exceptions going on right there. James has mastered the skill of dancing. What? Oh, well, everybody's loving like the speaker outside. They just keep dancing away. And I think little Ash has just gone and done some freelancing work on his own. Like literally, how goals is that? He just goes and works all on his own. And he's also watching a little bit of TV with Connor. I think this is nice that I do quite want those guys to have a nice little relationship together. Can we make sure all the homeworks have been done, please? And I think everybody's settling quite well into this new sort of setup of the house. And you guys made a really good point that it means this playroom is going to get a little bit of use as well, which I really like. In fact, Noelle, why don't you go and show us how it's done right now with a little bit of drawing? There you go. She also wants to be friendly to Asha. You cute little bean. And he can go over and encourage her, which I like, you guys. And to celebrate everybody being here, and it's a Sunday, Salma's cooked a little rack of lamb, excellent quality because she's that good of a chef, asking everybody to come and get some beautiful Sunday lunch together because we've now got a huge household to try and feed you guys. So there we go, you guys, everybody's eating a beautiful Sunday meal together. I love that this household is really, really big again. Although it's definitely missing a certain furry companion. There's no furry companions in the house at the moment. And Bruno is, of course, buried out in the garden there, which is also really sad. And Asha just kind of has taken it upon himself to just not really get dressed while he's living at the house. Not quite sure how I feel about that. In fact, I'm noticing that Charlie Rose is also not dressed, you guys. But I think it's nice that, you know, we don't know how much time Salma and James have left. And I think they'd want to spend a lot of it with their kids. So it's nice that they've got both their kids under one roof, isn't it? In fact, three kids now since they're looking after little Mesa Rooney as well. And since we've got quite a few young adults now in the family, and we know, I swear, there's literally a pub within walking distance of this house, I thought it'd be nice of them to kind of invite little Abel out for a drink. Just the young adults heading out together. Might actually get Connor to invite little Erica out as well. So yeah, look, this is literally the bar, the Shrieking Llama, next door to the house that I think we've walked by, but I don't think we've ever actually been there. So we should definitely give it a go. That's like one of the best parts of moving to a house, finding all the cute little spots to go walk to and explore that are new. The only time we'd ever seen it is when we were walking Bruno, which is obviously just very sad now. I miss Brew Brew. So the whole gang is here. Charlie Rose has got herself all dressed up. You beautiful bean. And little Abel with his scruff, which you guys say you don't like, but I refuse to listen to this propaganda. And Eric is angry. She's angry quite a lot, you guys. Connor's gonna go ahead and get a round in because, you know, the Calorie Al-Arabis are pretty, they're a pretty well-off family. And then this is the pub. It's got a downstairs. Oh, which is like a bit of a games kind of room, like a bit of a private sort of room downstairs, which is pretty cool. And awkwardly, Granddad is here. Granddad is here with his club. I don't know what the club is. Oh, the good times. The good times are like a bar group. Okay. And it's a nice opportunity for Connor to kind of catch up a little bit with Erica. Oh, look, who's here? Ryland is here and Zaki is here too. But I'm trying to check, you know, has Connor actually broken up with all of those girls yet? She's still a girlfriend. She's still a girlfriend. She's still a girlfriend. Connor, you've still got four girlfriends. Five girlfriends. Six girlfriends. Seven. Seven girlfriends. Connor literally has seven girlfriends, so I'm not sure if little Erica's gonna want anything to do with it. What? Abel's heading off already. Abel, don't be going already. You only just got here. In fact, the whole point was to catch up a little bit with Abel since he's only just aged up. Why can't you challenge him? Never mind. Maybe Asha can challenge Charlie instead. Abel doesn't seem to be going anywhere, which is great. And these two are having a really nice chance just to catch up. I do have to be careful with them, though, because for whatever reason... Oh, no! The game doesn't think... The game used to think that they could potentially have, like, a romantic interest in each other because it didn't know they were cousins. I was going to say calories. It didn't know they were calories. It didn't know they were cousins, but it does now, so that's really good. Oh, now they can have, like, a proper bromance without any risk of romance, which is great. Oh, awkward. Look who's here as well. Connor's ex. She's kind of everywhere. Oh, and I guess Ryland will have come with Abel because those guys know each other now, too. And now Jesse's saying... Do you want to go to the nightclub? There's a great party going on. I know it's a Sunday night, but you know, if they're all out together, we'd be kind of rude not to, right? Although I'm saying that and it's not giving me the option to invite other people. So we're going to have to just give it a swerve, I think. Yeah, look at this. Charlie Rose and Abel have never properly chatted with each other. And she's also never properly met Erica either. And what's kind of nice is these three are hanging out. And there doesn't really seem to be any, like, awkwardness. It just seems to be friends. I think you guys are right. I think Erica was, like, literally an amazing friend for Connor. For Abel when he was going through his tough time. But maybe it is just a really nice friendship. Maybe that's kind of all it is. Oh, look, Kira's here as well. Quick, Charlie Rose, come do some chats with best friend O'Kira. I think it's nice that you guys still have a nice relationship together. So not only did they get to catch up with little Abel and co, but also little Kira. And this is literally how close this pub is. Pub is here. House is there. Why they don't go here more, I do not know. But it's pretty cool how close we live to the pub. Look at that. Back home straight away in a heartbeat. And I've got home and... Salma's trapped on the bed. Salma, what are you doing? Get down from there. Get down. Even she's like, what are you doing, Salma? Why is she following the bed? Look, I'm trying to delete it. And she keeps just following it around. Like, what is she even doing? What now? There you go. There you go. Freak. No, stop. There we go. Why was she in bed? Salma, I said you weren't guilty. You don't have to become a bed. So the little girly whirlies are off to school. Make sure you look after little Macy at school, Noelle, because I know you're popular and perfect. But this one's had a little bit of a tougher life, so make sure you're looking after her. Charlie Rose is also heading into work. Hopefully she's going to get a little promotion today. In fact, why don't we get everybody making friends and working hard and whatnot? I know making friends is the opposite of working hard. But I think, like, Macy in particular needs to have her own friend group. And then Connor, what is it that you're doing today? Or having a bit of a sleep in for yourself? I don't think so. You need to invite around all of your girlfriends and break up with them all. It's not going to be a very nice day for you today, okay? So, Aisha, we need to invite her around to the house. Mizuki, we need to invite... her round to the house. Destiny, she needs to come around too. Sophia also needs to come around. Shanna also needs to come around. Candy also needs to come around. Anvi also needs to come around. Oh my gosh, Connor, you are a bad'un. You are such a bad'un. Okay, the girlies are all arriving. I'm gonna have to get a group going so that I can keep track of them all. As they're arriving, he's got so many to call that he's still calling them round. What is wrong with this boy? Okay, I think we're getting there, but we've not got all of them yet. Is she one? Okay, she's not one. Candy is one, though. Okay, so time to get all the girlies outside for a little chat, Connor, don't you think? Look, there's so many of them and they're unaware of each other, just dancing. No idea what was going on, did they? Okay, girls, come round. It's time for a bit of a heart-to-heart with Connor. You guys don't know each other, but you all have one thing in common. Connor's mouth. Oh, there's so many of them that I can't even, like, heard them effectively. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Wow, she's making herself comfortable. There's meant to be 7. Where's Anvi? I can't find Anvi. There she is. Okay. Oh, man. Can we just go somewhere away with them all? I don't think your family wants to see this. I don't think anyone wants to see this. Let's get them all to come out over here. Oh, my gosh. Look at it. It's like a PE class in school. There's so many of them. Look at all the girls flocking to Connor. Like the pigeons before them. They are a flock, really. That's the only way to describe them. This is how many girls Connor hard at the same time. This is Connor's girlfriends. This is the lineup right here. No, girl, stay here, stay here, stay here, stay here, okay? All of you together here. Oh my gosh, look at them all. Look at them all. Okay, Connor, okay. So how are we gonna do this? You first, you're gonna have to ask to just be friends. More choices. Friendly. Ask to just be friends. Ask to just be friends. Ask to just be friends. We're getting there, you guys. I mean, he likes quite a range of women, I would say. You've got to hand that to him. Ask to just be friends. Oh, there's so many that I've run out of interactions. Wow. I feel like this one at least knows what's coming. She does not look impressed at all. She's very beautiful, though. Okay, Connor, off you go. Go and speak to your flock. Oh, look at this. Wow. Is he actually going to do this smoothly? Oh, Connor, they're all running away. They're all running away. I don't know how impressed she was. Oh, she was not happy about the situation, you guys. Oh, she wanted babies. She wanted babies with him. Connor, no. I think we've made a good dodge there. She is not happy about the asking to just be friends things, you guys. Abhorrent confrontation. Oh, I thought if he asked them to be friends, then they wouldn't have like a bad relationship after, but that does not seem to be the case at all. Okay, girl number one done, Mizuki. She is not impressed at all, you guys. She's pretty mad about the whole thing. Okay, let's move on to another girl. This time it's going to be Sophia. Let's ask Sophie. Oh, look at him. Straight in with a kiss with them all as well. They have no idea what's about to happen. Oh, she's off for a swim. Oh, what? What is he doing, you guys? He can't even break up with people, like, without flirting hard with them. Oh, how does she feel about the whole thing? She's been a little bit better about it, I think. Okay, she seems to have taken it a lot better. Okay, 2, 5 to go. Where are they? Where are the girls? Oh my gosh, they're all about the sauna. James is just like, I'm not even gonna ask. I am not even gonna ask. Okay, next up we've got Destiny. Can we go and speak to Destiny, please? I can already tell she looks mad already. But why did you have to go straight in with a kiss before you break up with them, Connor? That's harsh. She's already feeling tense. How's she gonna take it? How's she gonna take it? Oh? Oh, I think she took it. Oh no, she looked a little bit angry then. Okay, I don't think she's happy, you guys. I've never broken up with so many people in The Sims in such a short period of time. And I'm literally not even halfway through. She is a ball of sun heat worthy rage I'm getting from that. Okay, are we done? Is Destiny broken up with? Anvi, stop. Where are you going, love? You're next. Okay, you're going into the bathroom for this. You go straight in with the romance though, Connor. That's just confusing them. In fact, she got 2 kisses, you guys. And look in the mirror. He's like looking at the other girl because she's watching the whole thing. She is watching her get broken up with. Oh, guys. I think she's a little bit disappointed by the whole thing. She looks pretty sad. She does look pretty sad. I like how Salma's in with a drink being like, this is great fun. I wasn't sure how I was going to spend my Monday now that I'm retired. Watching Connor try and break up with 7 girls is just the thing I was looking for. Okay, who's next? Where are you? Where are you all? Girlies. I think they know what's happening and they're fleeing. That's the vibe I'm getting. Some of them are escaping before I've had a chance to break up with them. No, Candy, you stay right there. You're next. Oh, actually, it seems like this one here is going to be next. I feel like one of the girls has put bugs on him as like a revenge kind of thing because he's scratching himself. Why are they all coming out to watch? You guys don't need to watch this. No, Connor. You're not getting away with this. Look at him. He's covered. Someone's done something to him. And how is she taking it? Not so well, you guys. She's pretty angry about the whole thing. Oh, she's calling him trash. She said that he is literal trash. Literal trash. Okay, do we still have some girls to break up with? We've broken up with her. Okay, Candy's back. That's great. Because we can break up with her as well. I'm not getting an option to ask to just be friends. So I'm kind of thinking we have to actually break up. Oh, and Noelle is inviting over classmate Simon. Very cute. Oh, where are they? Okay, this one is a bit of a confrontational breakup, you guys. Oh, she's really sad. Oh, she is super unhappy about the whole thing. I don't know how she didn't see it coming, because she's the girl number six, but, you know. Oh, and apparently Noelle's found a mini Max to bring around. That kid looks a lot like a little Max. Okay, so who does that leave? Who is left? Who has escaped so far? Shanna, where are you, my love? You're the last one. You've done a real good job in hiding today. Oh, look at James just trying to make him feel better, like, oh, why do you come for a dance, angry woman that I don't know? Oh my God, guys, look at this kid. That kid is so Maxy. Wow. He's also really mad about something. Okay, guys, the final girl is there. She's walking all preppy now, but that won't be lasting for much longer. Let's go ahead and ask to just be friends. I've got him some medicine for his sickness. Oh, and he's still trying. One of them won't leave. One of them won't get the hint. And guys, he's still walking like that, but at this point, I kind of feel like he deserves it. I don't know. This is what you get, Connor. This is what you get. So he's very slowly and very strangely making his way over to her. Of course he has to start with a kiss. How all these girls were so attracted to him after seeing him walk, I will never know. Let's see what she makes of this whole let's just be friends thing. Oh, she's taking it well. She's taking it well. Not. Oh, actually, maybe she is. Because now they just have to go and have a little chat by the pool together. What? Also, Connor looks so Baywatch right now. So Baywatch right now. Oh, I tried changing his outfit to see if that would help it, but it won't. He's still doing it. I've no idea why Connor is cursed with this walk, but he is. And these guys have just been sat there chit-chatting for ages and ages. But they all seem happy, which is cute. Oh my gosh, one of Connor's girlfriends has just smashed up their dollhouse. What an absolute trollop. Wow, look at her walking all daintily. If you're smashing other things in our house, I'm gonna smash you in the face, just saying. And now she's laughing about it. How dare you? How very dare you? Look, when my two good little girls just sat there doing good work is, oh, she's a bit poorly. That's fine, I've got loads of medicine. Take some medicine, my love. Oh, it might be best to wait to take my, or not you, this one. There you go, my love. Take a little bit of medicine. Oh my gosh, everyone's ill. Ollie is a tiger, not Ollie, James is a tiger. James, you take some medicine too, please. Ash has been promoted to a technician at SpaceX. He now makes an additional $20 per hour and he got an astro model rocket and he can point out the constellations. How cute is that? And Macy is going through a clingy stage, you guys. Uh-oh. What should we do with this little volcano? Can I put it in here? There you go. Look, you can have it on your desk. You need to go and do your homework, young lady. Have you got... Oh, she's sick now as well. Everyone is sick, you guys. It's a rampage of sickness. It's a plague. It's a plague. Take your medicine too. Where's your homework? Where's your homework? Always having to buy the homework. Literally driving myself mad with it. Do your homework as well, lady. Well, Connor, you've had a pretty strong day for yourself. You've had to break up with 7 girls. It's been a tough one. I think you should probably get an early night. Life's hard when you don't have a job, but you've got 7 girlfriends. It's got 99 problems, and literally, I would say about 12 of them now are ex-girlfriends. Although, to be fair, he's gone to go help Macy with her homework, so he's redeemed himself a little bit, you guys. These guys are getting an early night after their hard day at work. I think these guys deserve a nice little date tomorrow. Oh my God, I took your guys' advice and broke Jacob with that other guy, and he's got married to another guy. He's got married to Sergio Romeo. I don't even know. I don't even know. And thank you, Jamie. Jamie just gave us £2,000 in child support payments. Thanks, James. I will break up Jake the Snake. I don't know why he keeps going Vegas and getting married, but he does. Connor's like, I don't need to sleep. Why do I need to sleep? I'm not getting up for anything. I think it's time you got a job, young man. He's like, but my job is being really good with the ladies. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, what? Stop. Extinguish yourself. Asher, come see and be your girlfriend. I don't know why she's out grilling because Salma's in there cooking omelets. Asher, like, mate, Asher, help out a little bit, for God's sake. Wow, and that is a pretty terrible way for Charlie to start her day, I would say. They're all like, quick, escape route. Oh, and look, there's going to be another fire in a minute because Salma's omelette's still on there. Another fire? Are you actually joking me? Where? Where is there a fire? Oh, I literally called it. I literally called it that there was going to be another fire. Look, even the gardener's freaking out. There was going to be another fire because of how long the omelets were on there for. Someone extinguish it. Wait, someone extinguish the fire, for God's sake. Where's the sprinklers? What's the point of having a fire alarm if it doesn't activate any sprinklers? The whole place is going to go up in flames. Quick, extinguish it. What are you guys doing? James is extinguishing it, finally. You're the oldest, so, you know, kind of your job. Oh, Bruno's mat's burning and everything. What awful, awful way to start the day. And Charlie Rose, I know you're horrible filth, but you need to go to work. Oh, Bruno's little rug and everything, you guys. It's too sad. Oh, and Connor's found the whole thing very tough. He's off for a nap. Is that got anything to do with the fact that I said you had to get a job today, Connor? Just saying. Oh, everyone's super tense at work and school now. This is not good. Stupid fire ruining everything. Oh, apart from Connor. Connor's not feeling tense. That's not really an emotion that Connor does. Oh, and now Connor's started the first meal of his day. A little fruit yogurt. Looking rather unimpressed with the world. Oh, it's hard. You had to make your own yogurt. You had to get the strawberry from the garden and put it on top. Oh, how did you cope, Connor? How did you cope? Okay, Connor, I've had just about enough of your sass. You don't even put your plate in the dishwasher. Wow. You are gonna get the butt in here and find yourself a job. Charlie Rose, I can understand why you'd be tense. You were on fire a few hours ago. So you can come home and have a lovely, nice bath. Try and calm down in your bath. Take a lovely mud bath, actually. Get your skin looking all gorgeous because you and Asher are going on a date. Connor, let's find you a job. It's going to be tough. I'm kind of thinking business is probably going to be the best job for him. I think he did manage to graduate on an A or a B. Like, he wasn't too bad. But I don't think he's got any drive to go any, like, he's not particularly focused in any area. Athlete is kind of tempting because he's always working out. Actually, he's always working out and he's got a really good bod. And it's the kind of like being a bodybuilder is like, oh, I'm a bodybuilder. I feel like bodybuilders tend to have full-time jobs as well. But for Connor, it's like, I'm just a bodybuilder. That's just kind of what I do. So I think his dad would be able to get him in on this because he starts off as a team mascot. So his dad's literally like the team I used to play for, like you could just dress up as a llama, Connor, just do something, okay? Just do something. Okay, so you start at 2 p.m. as well, which is great for Connor. I feel like he could deal with that. And little Charlie Rose is having a mud bath, getting all nice and ready for her date with Asher. I mean, you're still looking pretty scorched there. I'm surprised you look so relaxed because, you know, you're pretty burnt right now. Oh, wow, you guys, all that job hunting was real tough. Connor's gone back to his nap. At least the girlies are being good, doing their little homeworks together. Little pies. Look, I'm being good as well. I'm taking the plate and I'm putting it in the dishwasher. Boom. Oh my gosh, hey, I need to get out of the house. Wanna join me for fire and flames? No, because I'm probably going to get there and you'll set me on fire. That'll be why it'll be called Fire in the Flames from that point onwards. Ex-girlfriend Aisha. Connor's like feeling real happy with himself now because he avoided dying in flames. And look at this. Asher doesn't get off work until 9 p.m. Pretty sad, you guys. Never mind. This one still knows they've got a hot date planned in the city. So she's going to go try on some outfits. See what's making her look good. That looks very, very good, to be fair. I wouldn't wear that. That's probably not what I'd advise, if I'm being honest with you. I mean, you can change out that one now if you want. Yeah, see, that one's a winner. You should definitely wear that. I mean, that's also really nice, but it's a bit more, you know, going down to the pub with your mates. No, no, don't wear that. You were never even a vet. I don't even know why you have that. Did you steal that from Kira? And now you're sick. No, don't be telling me that. Here is some medicine. I've put it on your chair. Please take the medicine. There you go, feeling better. And then I quite liked the long dress. I thought that looked beautiful. I'm gonna ask you to change into the long dress, please, lovely. There you go. And then why don't you meet Asher in town? Although he's literally just got home, so scratch that. Asher, why don't we change your outfit as well? No, don't go joking, don't go joking. You should change into a nice smart outfit. You change into this one here, okay? And then you guys are gonna, no, stop joking. Asher, stop joking. Come back here. You stop that. You stop that right now. Oh my God. I'm desperate for a wee again because look, This is my last bit of peach juice.
Okay, let's go to the beautiful Rockside Gourmet. I can't bring them to Fire in the Flames because if I go there, like, it just messes up because it's like, well, why are you working? What you doing? This ain't a date. You can't have a date at a place you own. Oh, wow. Charlie Rose. How disrespectful. I told you what outfit to wear. Please don't question my fashion. Please just do as I say, okay? Asher, what beautiful table. Look at his little cheeky tattoos. He is such a tasty little meatball. Let's find a nice place to sit. What about out here on the balcony? So romantic. I know it's a table for four, but like I said, when me and Ali go places, we like to sit on a table for four and sit at the same side so we can hold handies. It's just how we roll. And bless him, look, Asher is literally still tense about the fact that his girlfriend was on fire. Literally, he hated that entire situation, which you would kind of hope, wouldn't you? You don't want him to be like, oh, my girlfriend was on fire. It was great. Her hair's all singed. Apparently, it's almost Noelle's birthday, you guys. Look, they're doing a proper little Ali and Claire sitting on the same side, getting all flirty. Let me order for the table. I want to keep that flirty mood up. Then we're going to be doing some nice flirtiness as well. Oh my God, please don't tell me you've got stinky armpits. Beautiful wine. And I forgot the food here isn't quite as special as it is in Fire in the Flames. Never mind. You're going to get this and you're going to get this. And no, guys, he just had stinky stuff in his inventory, which I've removed. So they're both in a flirty mood. He wants to level up in his charisma. That's not very flirty. What's a bit more flirty than that? Flirt with somebody. Oh, Asher, why didn't you say something earlier? Sure, you've literally got Charlie Rose looking absolutely very highlightery, I would say. Maybe got a bit crazy here. But very, very beautiful. Charlie's also in a flirty mood. She wants to schedule a date. You're already on one, so maybe not. And these guys, you know, have moved, like, the fact that he's moved in with her to look after her parents as they get older, I think literally speaks volumes about how strong their relationship is. Like, that's a really big thing to ask a boyfriend to do. And the fact that he's done it, I think, is pretty amazing. He wants to kiss you guys. She wants to tell a naughty joke. Charlie Rose. And I've got to admit, I am kind of thinking that if a guy is willing to move in with you, for looking to look after your parents with you as they get old, I'm thinking you ought to put a ring on it. That is exactly what I'm thinking today. And I know with most of our Sims, we've kind of done it where the guy Sim proposes to the girl Sim. But I think Charlie Rose is going to break the mold. She's going to break the internet, Charlie Rose. And I think she's going to say thank you to Asher in a big way by asking him if he'd like to spend the rest of his life with her. But first of all, can we get some, like, wine? Like, where is our service? Hello? Finally, she comes to take our order. What have you been doing, Mariko? Being slow, that's what I see. Oh my gosh, it is literally 3 a.m. in the morning, and I am yet to see any food coming our way, you guys. I don't know what's going on, but they're just not being served. Please tell me you've got some food for us. What are you doing? What are you even doing? Please tell me that's for us. Please, please, please tell me that food is for us. Luckily, the company is really good. They don't seem to mind, even though Ash is getting a little bit sick. So at least their food is finally here, you guys. Now they're eating in total silence. That's how hungry they are. You know, you're so hungry that you don't even eat. And unfortunately, Ash is looking a little bit sick, so Charlie, if you want to do what you want to do, you're going to have to do it quite soon, okay? Maybe profess some undying love. Do a little kiss of Rooney. And she does have the option, you guys. Okay, okay. Oh my gosh, she's literally, she's prepared some notes, you guys. She has actually prepared some notes. This waitress needs to just go and get out of the way. There we go. Okay, guys, it's happening. It's happening! I know it's like, don't you dare stand in front. Good girl. I know it's the non-traditional way, but they've got a non-traditional life. And I think it's lovely, you guys. So there we go. Charlie Rose and Asher are now engaged to each other. Don't you dare be getting married without asking me first, though. And the staff have literally switched the lights off. They're like, yeah, you guys need to go. It's late. Okay, the restaurant has been paid, but home right now. So hopefully you guys are happy with the fact that these two got engaged. I think it was a long time coming. They've had like a long relationship that's been on and off since they were very, very young. But now they finally agreed that they're going to tie the knot because Asher moved in to look after her parents. Like, it doesn't get much more committal than that. I think it's beautiful. I think there's only one way to celebrate such gorgeous, gorgeous news, and I think you guys know exactly what it is. Look how amazing they both look in their outfits, by the way. Literally so amazing.
Yes.
I love his little trousers. Little good-looking googie eggs. Their matching jumper and dress combo. Actually love that so, so much. So guys, it seems like Usher is definitely going to be a permanent fixture in the household. And those guys are now engaged. Connor has broken up with 7 girls. Means he could now have a chance with Erica. And he got himself a job. The two girls have got an amazing little room that they're sharing together. And are both doing a really good job at being good at school. Macy's fitting in with the family really well. And actually seems really happy. And Salma is not only innocent, but she's enjoying her time with beautiful husband. Oh, I say she is. Maybe she's not. But we'll say she's enjoying her time with beautiful husband James. So this is the big new Suburbs household. Let me know if you like it with all these additional characters in it. And if you're happy with the decisions that we made in this episode. If you are, drop some comments below. And if you're not, also drop some comments below. And I hope you enjoyed this episode. I'll see you guys in another one. Thank you so much for watching.